Hi guys, I'm back with a new video, and this video is for Pierre in France, and it's a video about an initiation that went terribly wrong, that had nasty side effects, and everything was completely messed up. So I'm trying to help him out, and the first thing I noticed when he contacted me was a very severe stomach ache and burping and yawning, pain in the hips and in the knees, especially the right hip. So all these aches and pains and struggles prevent him to get into a healthy energy flow. Now, you all know by now that I am looking for the beautiful infinity symbol going this way. And in Pierre's case, it was don't laugh, I'm in my underwear. So instead of making a beautiful eight, it was like something like this, and then it went something like that. But the good thing is, at least he kept shaking his hips, so that's a sign that he really wants to literally shake off whatever the hell happened to him. So if he would refuse to move at all or something, then there would be something seriously wrong, something irreversible, reversible or whatever, but he was sort of really trying to get into the rhythm, but he failed, and he had something going to the right, and I don't know, it was weird and funny at the same time. So the good thing was he wants to get rid of whatever happened to him. Now, then I checked, I pulled down the desired energies from, let's say, the source, and instead of a beautiful flow going down and surrounding the Heli, it went like in shocks, in no beautiful flow, no beautiful like a shower. It was like bricks falling down and then building up a new energy. So that was one thing. Then I used the angelic flame, which is a flame in the shape of a heart, and I wanted to put it into his heart chakra, but everything was covered in black, sticky, nasty, gooey dirt. So what I did is what I normally, the flame does this by itself. You place it in somebody's heart chakra and it starts to radiate and expand and slowly and organically conquer the whole system. But now I had to hold it, and I just slowly swirled it around and made circles inside the head too, because he's full of fear, insecurities, he lacks, like I said, confidence and self-awareness, and he doesn't feel empowered enough to live his life the way he wants to organize the whole thing. So I and then I saw at least 5 women figures surrounding him, whispering things in his ear. So I was sort of clearing his ear so one could hear these voices better, and also will be able to dismiss these voices and make his own choices instead of being manipulated by whoever is behind this. So then I went through the throat, because there's a lot of fear and stress and shame blocked inside it, and I wanted to take the weight of his shoulder, so I used the same flame to do that. I wanted to take away a little bit of this stomach ache, but I sort of didn't manage to get rid of it all. So the weird thing was that normally the energy comes down very, very smoothly and slowly and softly and gentle and surrounds the etuni or heli. In this case, it was just in shocks. Like if you have a plumbing system that fails and you open the tap and it's the noise was quite similar. And then I wanted to proceed with the whole process, but I used another flame because this person kept grabbing for this flame, eager to use it, because for some odd reason he liked this whole clearing process. So one I used on the inside and one I used on the outside, and I took away as much as possible. Ritual bath. It felt like he couldn't stop. He didn't want me to stop doing it. But then I was like, okay, I'm just giving you both flames, and one is going to be in your stomach, one is going to be in your heart, and it will sort of burn away every type of negativity, spiritual negativity away, and it will eventually start to, well, same if you start sweating, it makes you able to release heat but also toxins and salt, and there's a diet problem definitely, and the lower chakras are dominated by also fear and stress and not feeling comfortable in this world, and again a lack of confidence and relying on other people instead of owning your own life, making your own decisions, being able to face the world and be confident and not be afraid to make mistakes. Just if you make mistakes, you can just make some adjustments and go into the right direction again. So I have to repeat this, I will do this later, but it sort of gives you an idea of what it is I'm working on. So Pierre, if you're watching this, this is for you, and I hope you will feel confident and strong and empowered again, and the stomach aches, well, stick to your diet. See you next time. Bye.